Today we have the opportunity to speak with Dr. Katie Alaniz, the Assistant Professor of Education at Houston Baptist University. Katie, welcome.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
I really love the area you're in. Your primary focus is curriculum and instruction with an emphasis in digital learning.
Yes, sir.
And collegial coaching.
Now, yes.
Man, that sounds like Jeff Bezos, Amazon stuff. I love it. What is it? Tell me what it's all about.
So we have a big emphasis on collegial coaching for technology integration. And as you probably might imagine, today's teachers have sometimes a difficult time incorporating technology into their instructional practices. They have many demands that are placed upon their time, you know, pressing demands for accountability, lots of things to think about. And so sometimes it's hard for them to research the latest and greatest technology, and let alone implement it. That can be very difficult for them to find meaningful ways to implement it into their curriculum. And so Dr. Wilson, my colleague, and I have written a book called Naturalizing Digital Immigrants.
I've heard about this book.
Yes.
Okay, let's show it off. And it's Naturalizing, get a tight shot on this here, Michael. Naturalizing Digital Immigrants.
Yes.
The Power of Collegial Coaching for Technology Integration.
Yes.
And there you are, Katie Alaniz and Don Wilson. Explain.
Y'all
wrote that textbook?
We did. And so this is actually used as a text in one of our courses. It's actually our capstone course for our MED program with an emphasis in instructional technology. And so all of the students in that course are required to coach colleagues on their school campuses for 45 hours over the course of a semester, about 15 hours with three different colleagues, 45 hours total. And as they are coaching these colleagues, they're working shoulder to shoulder with them to help them integrate technology in meaningful ways into their curriculum. And so it's an internship process that they go through. And I have to tell you, this actually came about as I was an MED student here at HBU, and Dr. Don Wilson was my professor, and I was tremendously impacted by that course. I was asked to coach some colleagues on my school campus. I was teaching second grade at the time at a private school here in Houston, and I had the opportunity to coach three different colleagues on my campus. And I saw some fabulous things happen over the course of the semester. Some of them who began as teachers that were very hesitant to integrate technology just because, you know, they weren't quite sure how to do it, how it might roll out. As I was working alongside them, I saw them integrate technology in the most powerful ways, and it really impacted their students hugely. I mean, just tremendously. We saw great gains in student engagement and achievement. And so I was sold on this method after I went through it as a student. And so then when I became a professor here, Dr. Wilson and I were able to work together to write this book and now use it as a textbook in our course.
You know, Katie, that is fantastic.
I
heard all about this book, and I was thinking, I was going to ask my associate, can you get me one of those? So I'm going to try to take one before you leave.
I would love to give you this copy.
We're talking to Dr. Katie Alaniz, the Assistant Professor of Education at Houston Baptist University. You, along with Dr. Don Wilson, Professor of Education, were invited to present at the Association for the Advancement of Computing and Education, AACE, Annual Society for Information Technology and Teacher Education Conference, which took place in Austin, Texas, March 6-9, 2017. Yeah. That had to have been a very crowning moment.
It was exciting. It truly was a blessing, most definitely. And we're seeing now, as we've been presenting at these different conferences, that there is a huge emphasis that's being placed on coaching because people are seeing how powerful this method of professional development is for our teachers. And, you know, we, for so long as educators, have emphasized the importance of differentiation in instruction and making learning personalized for our students. But the issue is, for many educators, professional development has not been rolled out in that way. So, you know, you attend these professional development sessions, and teachers are often removed from the context of their own classrooms. And so they're learning a lot of information, but as they go back to their school settings, it's difficult for them to find ways to meaningfully apply these new technological innovations into their classroom instruction, right? Because they've been removed from the context of their classroom settings as they're learning. And so with coaching, you know, what happens is teachers are given professional development in the context of their own classroom settings, and it's making such a tremendous impact because they're experiencing this differentiated instruction as educators, right? And so that makes a huge difference for them.
Well, the education major at HBU is a real growth engine, and it sounds like that they're not getting old school thinking here, right?
No, absolutely not.
I mean, why don't you just elaborate that if a if a student enrolls at HBU, they don't just leave with an education degree, but they leave with some sophistication of digital usage in the training and teaching process.
Yes.
Okay, absolutely. So what are the chapters? I want to just give us a synopsis of what that textbook is covering.
Look here. We'll flip right to the table of content. Contents. Okay, so one thing that we talk about is bridging the great divide. And so for some of our teachers who, you know, might consider themselves to be digital immigrants, they haven't grown up in the digital age, and all of a sudden they're responsible for teaching these digital natives. You know, students who have grown up in the digital age, they're used to having technology at their fingertips. They're typically very experienced and skilled in using technology. And so our today's teachers have to know how to make technology applicable for the students in the classroom setting. And so bridging the great divide, we also talk about investigating coaching programs within educational settings. So kind of looking at what's currently out there. Jim Knight has written a tremendous book on collegial coaching in particular, but he doesn't focus on collegial coaching for instructional technology. And so that's what this focus is, for instructional technology, because we found that for instructional
technology. And so instructional technology is that teacher in communicating to the student in the classroom environment?
Yeah, using technology in any way to enhance the classroom environment.
Okay.
Absolutely. So it's in some ways to enhance the curriculum. And you know, one focus that we really have on this in this book is that content is king, and so we want curriculum to drive instructional technology use and not vice versa. So instead of, you know, constantly promoting the latest and greatest tools for our teachers and saying, find a way to use this tool in your curriculum, we want our coaches to sit down, look at the curriculum with the teachers side by side, and think, how can we further enhance this curriculum through the digital tools that we have available? And you know, sometimes that may mean that we don't use digital tools in this particular lesson or throughout this unit. But if we're going to use them, let's use them in a meaningful way. So let's use them in a way that empowers our students to create new things, not just be consumers of information, but to create. Let's use them in meaningful ways that empower our students to collaborate. You know, we focus on the six C's of 21st century learning, which would be communication, collaboration, cross-cultural competencies, citizenship, I have to name them all, let me think, creativity, critical thinking. Mm-hmm. So we want to focus on those things, and how can we use digital tools to enhance these skills for our students.
Okay, and give me, what else is in there?
I'm
really excited about that book.
Thank you. So we also, we have a lot of research actually in this book that talks about the need for technology integration coaching in school settings, and how sometimes teaching can be a very isolating profession. You know, sometimes teachers consider their classrooms their domain, and they shut the door and kind of, you know, sit there and just plan by themselves. But through coaching, they have the opportunity to really collaborate with others and learn from others. And you know, two heads together are better than one. You know, and so you get to think with your coach, what are some ways that I could really develop the curriculum that I currently have in place? And then we also talk about just the basics of coaching. What does it mean to be a coach? And you know, so as a coach, you're not really an evaluator. You're not judging this person. You're a colleague, right? You're a collegial coach. So you're someone that's not walking in with a clipboard and ready to assess their every move, but instead you're there to support them. You're there to work side by side with them to help enhance their curriculum. And you know, when I was a teacher and enrolled in the MED program and helping my colleagues integrate technology into their classrooms, I saw that they felt very comfortable working with me just because I was their colleague. You know, right. I wasn't in a supervisory role, and so they felt like they could share their problems with me.
Sure.
They knew that they could trust me. And actually that ties into the next chapter. We talk about developing quality coaches. So what are some of the characteristics of quality coaches? And as an administrator is thinking, who might I want to ask to be a coach in my school setting? Some things to look out for would be that person has impeccable relational skills, that person is trustworthy, that person has the heart of a teacher, right, and a lifelong learner. Mm-hmm. And so that they're not there just to share information, but also to learn, you know, from the teachers that they're working with. So it's a mutual learning experience, which is really powerful. And then we talk a lot also about beginning on the right foot. So what are some steps that you can go through as you're thinking about how you might effectively coach the teachers in your classroom settings? And then acquiring faculty buy-in. That's a big one. Because again, you know, we think about teaching being an isolating profession sometimes, and so some teachers they don't want to welcome others to come into their classroom and to help them out, you know, in different ways.
Sure.
And so we want to make sure that as we're rolling this out to a faculty, we're acquiring their buy-in, that they feel invested in the program, that they see the power of this and the potential of this. And then we have a conclusion that just basically ties it all together. And so that's a very brief overview.
And this textbook, can I get my hands on it
for
just a second?
Of course.
Is this used in the graduate area?
It is.
Okay.
Yes, it is.
And mm-hmm. And you have your own textbook, so.
Yes.
I suppose someone who has an undergraduate degree in education,
mm-hmm.
similar to what you had,
yes.
you came here to do the MED,
yes,
right?
Yes, I did. Yes, sir.
And why is the MED at HBU? I mean, this looks really good flipping through it. But why is the MED so popular at HBU? And what kind of promise do you feel like it has in the future?
For me as a student, I can say that it was absolutely life-changing. I honestly did not have any aspirations to be anything beyond a second grade teacher when I was first approached by Dr. Wilson. She actually came to our school and showed us that there would be a cohort that would be taking place for private schools in the Houston area. And my husband was actually the one who pushed me to be a part of the cohort. He said, you know, Katie, you're the type of person who is a lifelong learner, and I think you'll really benefit from this experience.
I love those husbands that push their wives forward.
He's been a great supporter,
yeah.
the whole way through. But he really pushed me to do it. And so I thought, you know what? He's a wise man. I'm gonna take his advice. I'm gonna do it. And I have never had a single regret. It was phenomenal. And what I think really sets our MED program apart from others is that it's very hands-on. The professors are so very invested in their students' lives, not only their academic lives, but also their personal lives. I've told Dr. Wilson many times that she became like a second mom to me through that program.
Wow.
Because our cohort was only 12 people. We got to know each other very, very well.
Yeah.
We pushed each other to succeed. I felt like I can't quit on these people. You know, I have to finish the program because these are my buddies. You know, we've gone all the way through together, and so that was such a feeling of accomplishment. And some of these people are still my best friends to this day. Some have moved to other states and we still keep in contact. I have worked alongside some of them for many years, and so it was just a very, very powerful experience for me. And I will tell you that one very special thing about the MED program is that there's a great emphasis on project-based learning and authentic assessment. So rather than just taking mini exams, you know, in the instructional technology program in particular, our students create projects that are immediately applicable to what they'll be doing in the classroom. And
mm-hmm.
so, you know, I felt very invested in the experience because I knew through each and every project that we created, this is something that the very next day I could take to my second grade students and actually show them, present to them, and use in the classroom. And it was just mind-blowing. And I remember when I
can only imagine digital technology with elementary kids, how they mess light up.
They love it. They love it. It engages them. It fascinates them. It gets them excited about learning. It's just phenomenal. I mean, this was life-changing for me because really and truly, I was not very effective at incorporating technology into my classroom prior to this program.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Dr. Wilson and the other professors that I had in the program just really opened my eyes to all that was out there and how powerful it is for our students. And it it changed me completely.
How did Dr. Wilson get on the cutting edge of this whole thing and not be antiquated as, or, you know, it's typical until, you know.
Right.
I remember one day when, you know, one of my children gave me a 60-second lesson on one of the social media platforms. You know, they only give 60 seconds.
Right.
And if you don't learn it in 60 seconds, Dad, you know, you're hopeless. But, you know, how did she break out to get into this area?
You know, I will say that she pushes herself to be a lifelong learner. She is consistently researching. She's always finding new articles to share. She's a big user of Twitter. And she asks all of her students to follow her on Twitter. And so anytime she pushes out something that she's found, they have it as well. And so she's consistently researching, learning more. And she also really modeled for me what it looks like to be submitting proposals to professional conferences and going to those conferences and presenting, and then also networking and learning from those around you. And so that has made a huge impact as well.
Now, for teachers, the Master of Education, it does have a defining mark to it in your career path, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
It puts you in a whole different pay scale, et cetera.
Absolutely.
I mean, give us some of the, I call it FAB, the features, advantages, and benefits of taking the extra step.
I like it. So you're exactly right. You do, in many cases, actually, I've not heard of a single school or school district that wouldn't offer increased pay for having obtained an MED. And beyond that, I would say, you know, most importantly, it just opens your eyes to so many things that you may not have taken as an undergraduate student. You know, you may not have pulled from your experience because, you know, as an undergrad, you're just trying to learn to be a teacher. You know, you just want to survive the day-to-day life in the classroom. But when you embark on an MED program, you're going above and beyond. You're really enhancing your practice as an educator and thinking more about, you know, how you can make every lesson, every unit for your students the most meaningful that it can be. And so I think it just opens your eyes to a whole new world out there. And administrators recognize that, you know, when they see that their teachers are striving to obtain, you know, a MED or, you know, even a doctoral degree, that's a huge deal. That really sets them apart.
So. And we know, too, that, in fact, we've put this out in Pillars, the publication of HBU, that the more education, the more income.
Absolutely.
And it's a reality. Now, so you actually use your own textbook in the course?
We do.
Is it augmented?
Yes.
What else did you bring here today?
This is actually another textbook. This is the second book that we wrote together.
Are you kidding? Yeah. And tell me you're going to give this one to me, too, please.
I am going to give it to you. Yes, I brought it just for you. Yes. Yes. So Digital Media in Today's Classrooms, the Potential for Meaningful Teaching, Learning, and Assessment. And this is one that we actually use in a multimedia course that we have for our graduate students.
And so is this graduate or undergraduate?
This is graduate as well,
Graduate as well. Now, are these both textbooks in the same MED or are they separate?
They're in the same program, separate courses.
Okay, very good. The Potential for Meaningful Teaching, Learning, and Assessment. Now, I could only imagine that if you're a teacher and you get an MED and you go to a school that really doesn't have this technology or has preliminarily started it and you become a catalyst, you probably become a rock star in the whole school, don't you?
Yes, you do. Absolutely. We've seen it happen before. Yes. And actually, many of our students in our MED program with an emphasis in instructional technology have gone on to become instructional technologists for their school or their district. That's actually exactly what happened to me after I graduated from the program. That very next year, I was offered a promotion as an instructional technologist. And so it was just a huge blessing, all around, huge blessing. And I know that my administrator saw, you know, hey, she's learning these new things in this program. I think she can incorporate them into not only her classroom setting, but help colleagues incorporate those principles as well.
You know, and it's very true that I have many colleagues that they're incredible academics, they're incredible theologians, but when you say to them, set up a website or Twitter or search engine optimization or search engine marketing or any of this, they really don't know. And we live in such a different world.
Right.
I mean, who would have ever thought that a store could be open named Amazon that you don't even transact money?
It's amazing.
And yet 100 Macy's are closing. And Nordstrom's is trying to put a bar in the men's department to reinvent itself. We are in, speak for a minute, of just what incredible changes are taking place and what are going to take place in the next decade, right, in your opinion.
Yeah, absolutely. Our world is ever changing. And in my opinion, I feel that we are needing now to prepare our students for jobs that have not even been invented yet, have not even been thought up, right? And so that's difficult. How do we prepare our students for something that we can't even imagine at this point in time based upon, you know, the current technologies that we have and how they're consistently evolving? And so, you know, we have to help our students to have the mindsets of being lifelong learners, being willing to adapt easily to change, being willing to research, you know, the latest things that are coming out, and having those skill sets that help them to, you know, meaningfully apply the knowledge that they're obtaining. And it's a big job, most definitely. It's a big job. And so that's what the six C's of 21st century learning. These are important things that our students will need for the future. And, you know, one in particular, just to give an example, collaboration. You know, I actually was just talking to one of my graduate classes yesterday about how, you know, as I was growing up, I feel like I didn't have very many opportunities to collaborate with my classmates on different projects. You know, it just wasn't, it wasn't how we did education then. Yeah. You know, we kind of worked independently. And so then when you would have the opportunity to collaborate, it could sometimes be hard because you hadn't yet developed those skill sets, you know, that skill set of collaboration rather than competition, right? And now our students are interconnected. You know, my online students who have never met one another face to face are interconnected, right? And so they have to know how to collaborate, and we have to be able to help them use digital tools in effective ways to collaborate. So there's a lot of potential out there.
Wow, I'll tell you, Katie, this is really amazing. And now, is this MED online yet?
It is online?
Okay, let's talk about that.
Yes.
You all have already filmed this, and it's being offered?
It's being offered online, yes. Yes.
And how can a potential student learn about that? Go to what? HBU.edu?
Right, absolutely. And our program listings are right there. And so it's the MED with an emphasis in instructional technology.
Oh, fantastic. Yes. Our greatest compliment to both Dawn Wilson and to you, and to your creativity. What a gift you both are to Houston Baptist University. Take just a minute and invite any prospective student to check out why they ought to check out the undergraduate and postgraduate education opportunities at Houston Baptist University.
Absolutely. So I would highly recommend that you do explore the programs that we have here on campus as well as online. You will receive a once-in-a-lifetime experience, very hands-on learning experience where your professors are highly invested in your success, not only academically, but your personal success, your personal development and growth as an educator. And I can say from personal experience that it was life-changing for me. And so I would highly recommend that you do some research and consider the wonderful things that we have to offer here at HBU.
Thank you so much, Katie, for joining us today. Look forward to bringing you and Dawn back and talking about technology.
Absolutely.
And everything that's happening in the future. And we want to welcome all of our listeners to HBU.edu, where they can find out much more about what is one of America's great universities.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. It's been a blessing to be here today.